Jason Naismith, alias Commander Peter Quincy Taggart. We'll do that again. And who's played by Tim Allen, arrives fashionably late and proceeds to milk the attention like a rock star. Nah, we'll do that again. Naismith falls asleep drunk in front of an... Get it right there. Meanwhile, the rest of the crew are opening some tech hardware store. And, again, the commander isn't with them. And now Naismith must... Hate it when that happens. Their fuel ball is damaged. Yes, I know it's a beryllium sphere. Actually, I'm not going to do any lines to camera in this jumper. Can't even get me ad libs right. So there's not much hope for me. But still, we try. They chance upon a refinery. Get it right there. The commander and the bridge bunny finally reach the core shutdown squitch. Take that. Ah, the big clunky red button at the back. And oh dear, that's on camera. Link roll. Take one. Released in 1999, Galaxy Quest can best be described as a parody of Star Trek, crossed with a Trek actor's worst nightmare. But what am I doing telling you about it? Let's dig in and see for ourselves. Whoever thought swearing in a PG-13 movie was a good idea should effing die. Yay! They managed to shut down the road. Come on, dear. Young Officer Shinohara discovers a troubling link between the new HyperOS and incidents of Rampage. Fellow labor pilot and designated female of the movie, and whisks her off for some eats. Okay,
we'll call her out there and go and get tea.
But a chance discovery while they're out leaves Shinohara. Philosophizing. Take one. Welcome to my house of love. Now, either. Gotta do the arm thing. Established it in the last episode, gotta do it. So, this is a bit of a cheat, but I don't care. Ooh, this is the good one. Oh, pull yourself together, dear. Goto, you magnificent, I read your book! But I'm willing to bet you've got a very short attention. Look a bunny! Still can't believe I'm actually gonna put that in. Okay. Shooter Yahoo's Linux. And the sign off. So thanks for watching. And join me next time for more fun and frolics. Bye now. So thanks for watching. And be sure to join me next time for more fun and frolics. Mata ne! And that's on camera. Lovely. Yeah, alright, we'll dispense with all this poshy stuff. But I'm keeping the tea. Actually, this is on camera, isn't it? Oh no, my great secret is revealed! Except nobody's ever actually going to see this video. Well, not the video, fortunately. I'm wasting film. Bond atop the Statue of Liberty. 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 Come on. Genjo Sanjo. Come on. Which predictably this is. Damn. Drake faces down Hiraga when Yomiko burks in. America, please drill into your actors the British short O. Link roll. It's take two. Oh well. So grab your reading pad. EU law actually mandates that I have to say buzz off here. She really loves that book. Well, it's Thursday and I'm only just recording this now. Take two! Cheers! backlit animation. Though I want to say it so clearly as two words. TRON is arguably the first full-length feature to use large amounts... One more time. TRON is arguably the first full-length feature to use... Come on, dear. Okay. Next line. Oh boy. Meet clever. Kevin Flynn. Come on. Now, do we want to say Laurie or Laurie here? Annan. The technical trio head back to Edcom. But after a brief exchange with the NPC. NPC? MCP!
Oh man, this isn't happening. Only things are happening.
No, we need a better but oh dear here. But oh dear! TRON contacts Beam Program Transport. Transport Program. And receives the information to erase the NPC. NPC? MCP! One more time. Link roll, take one. Greetings, programs! Greetings. So, rev up your light cycles. This is TRON. Meet Kevin Flynn. It's not difficult, dear. It's not Laurie, it's Laura. You dev! And now, the light. Actually, I'll give that a couple of seconds. But I'm not really score? Come on, dear. Milliseconds? Microseconds? Nanoseconds? Picoseconds? It's comforting to know that the gods are as clueless as the rest of us. That was gonna be a good one. End of line.